Yes. So simultaneously, we are going to be live on YouTube. Remember, all what we speak here is going to be available on YouTube with a delay of approximately 10 to 11 seconds. Okay. So that is just one thing which you all need to know. And second, should there be any questions regarding this entire session, all of you can ask your questions regarding this entire session whenever you want to ask on our channel on Kezala, which is what we have done. So that I think that is something which is very exciting for each and every one of you. Now, this is going to be a very important session, predominantly designed for family physicians. It is going to be a very short and sweet session, which is going to last for approximately 12 to 15 minutes. And I'm going to try and tell you the importance of pap smear. Now, remember, as family physicians, you know one thing for sure, that in our country, if we look at women, still one of the most important and leading cause of cancer in our country remains to be cancer of the cervix. All right. What is important is cancer cervix is something that can be screened. Okay. So that means if you have a yearly follow-up visit coming to your hospital from a lady, as far as doing a pap smear is concerned, this can be evaluated on a yearly basis because it is believed, all right, it is believed that one of the most important causes of having cancer of the cervix is going to be a precedence of an infection with HPV, that is human papilloma virus. We are all aware of this. We are all also aware of the fact that HPV virus or human papilloma virus is going to get initiated following sexual exposure. All right. In our country, apart from sexual exposure, the other things which you should be knowing about is a very poor genital hygiene. And something that used to exist very commonly in our country, and that is a lot of deliveries. Okay. A lady would normally end up delivering close to 4 to 5 kids, and repeated deliveries or repeated childbirth is also one of the predisposing factors for development of cancer of the cervix. But two most important factors, which blindly every family physician should note down and remember, is poor genital hygiene and sexual exposure. Now, remember, in all the countries, okay, who follow a very good and a very strict, okay, very good and a very strict screening program in the form of pap smear, the usual testing is recommended on a yearly basis from the age of initial sexual exposure or from the age of 21. All right. We all know this. We all know this for sure, for a fact. If there are, let's say, I believe there are 150 to 170 family physicians who have logged in right now to listen to this session. If you ask yourself, how frequently do you do pap smear for all the women who are visiting your hospital or all the women who are visiting your clinic? The answer is not going to be possible to answer as well. I'm sure so many will not be able to answer because it is not something which is being done very commonly. All right. There could be inhibitions. I understand and I agree to it. There could be inhibitions. There will be people who will say that there is no space. There will be people who will say that women are not willing to do a pap smear in a local family physician clinic. There could be male family physicians who will say that I don't have a female compounder, so I cannot do all these things. But remember one thing, screening and doing pap smear, okay, is something which is so basic, no? It requires an investment of less than 500 rupees. You need a good Cusco speculum, a Cusco speculum 3. Three Cusco speculum, small, medium, large, is available at 190 rupees of stainless steel, which can be sterilized in your local family physician clinic. Okay. Every pathologist who sets up a pathology or a microbiology laboratory will 100% offer testing for pap smear because it is the easiest thing to test. The spatula which is needed is something which is commonly called as IR spatula. Okay. I will just draw that and also explain what is that. And the fixative is our routine ethyl alcohol. So it just needs to be smeared on a slide. And once it is smeared on a slide, it can be sent for routine testing. Very, very simple. Pap smear routine testing is not a very expensive exercise. In the last year, some of you will recollect that we had tied up with NIMA, that is National Integrated Medical Association, and we had conducted colposcopy camps across Maharashtra. You will not believe, total, we screened 5,160 patients. 5,160 women were screened by us and we identified 4 cases of cancer cervix in that. 4 cases of cancer cervix, which is so important. So imagine if everybody in our country starts doing it, just imagine what blessing it is going to be for the women of our country. Just imagine that. Okay. But in today's session, I'm just going to give you a very basic idea of what is PAP test. Why are we trying to do it? What are we trying to see? And what are we trying to understand? I'm not going to bore you much. It's going to be very short and sweet session. You will understand why to do Pap smear, how to do Pap smear, and what is the interpretation will be discussed in our next session on next Monday. Okay. So I will start the screen sharing now. Rashmi, when I was audible all this while?
Yes. Perfect.
Perfect. Okay. Fine. So I've just started with the screen sharing. I believe my screen will be visible to each and every person now. Okay. So let me just open up the notes and let me just start with the things which I want to convey. Okay. Now see, I will just write down Pap smear here. Is the Pap visible? If I'm writing Pap smear, it's visible, Rashmi Ben?
Yes.
Okay, very good. So see, we all know that the female, no, the uterus, the lower part of the uterus is called as the cervix. We all know this, okay? So this is the cervix, all right? And this is the vagina, okay? This entire part is the vagina. So now what I'm going to do for you is, what is Pap smear? Pap smear is basically taking scraping of these cells, okay? These cells, these are the cells which we are trying to scrape off. So let me just give you an enlarged version of this. So if I'm just taking this and I'm enlarging it for each and every one of you, it is going to be something like this. See, the entire cervix. Okay. Large version, huh? And vagina here. See. So what happens is, we all know that there is something called as endocervix. Endocervix means the part which is inside. Let me draw it in a different color. See, this is the endocervix. Endocervix secretes the mucus. This is what we all know, huh? This is endocervix, see? And then there is exocervix. I will draw the exocervix in red color, see? This is the exocervix. All this is the exocervix, okay? So, the part where the exocervix and the endocervix meet with each other, I will draw that in green color. This part, where both these endocervix and exocervix, they meet with each other. See, it's a different epithelium. Why is it a different epithelium? Let me just give you a highlight of that. Endocervix, no, is columnar epithelium. Columnar epithelium secretes mucus. And this is squamous epithelium. Vagina is lined with squamous epithelium. We all know squamous and columnar is different. So this zone, no, is called as transformation zone, which we call as TZ, transformation zone, or very simple, SCJ, that is squamo-columnar junction. Okay. So what happens is, this is the region where the squamous epithelium comes and tries to merge with the columnar epithelium, and HPV infection is very common here. HPV infections are very common here. Very, very common. Okay. Remember, the human body, especially the female body, is so brilliant. God has designed this structure so beautifully that usually whenever there is an HPV infection, it can get washed out. That means these cells, no, these green colored cells, which I'm now showing as transformation zone, these cells are shed out. So even if there is an HPV infection, on the first encounter of HPV infection, nothing happens to the lady. See this? This gets shed out. Whenever something gets shed out, it is called as exfoliation. See that? And what are we doing in Pap smear? In our Pap smear, we are trying to study these cells which are getting exfoliated. These cells from the transformation zone or squamo-columnar junction, which are getting shed, it is that what we are trying to study. So the obvious question which will come is, are, how is it going to help us? If the HPV infection is there and if that has been shed, that means HPV infection is out, no? So that is not the answer. Over a chronic, so I will add a new word to this now. Whenever there is a chronic repetitive HPV infection, along with the exfoliative cells, it goes and starts affecting the basement membrane also. It goes and starts affecting a little bit here also, little bit on the endocervix also. So the new cells which are growing in the transformation zone, all will have the changes which have occurred due to an HPV infection. Okay. And that is exactly what we are trying to find out in a Pap smear. Okay. Commonly, you would have studied that the Pap smear reporting is very common. See this? You would have heard this report, huh? If you see the report, chronic cervicitis. So that means it is inflamed, and that is what is causing chronic cervicitis. Common terminologies which we use is atypical significant cells, okay? That is called as ASCUS, or low-grade squamous intraepithelial or high-grade intraepithelial lesions. This we'll discuss in the next Monday session. I also want to tell each and everyone that ideal age to start is either sexual exposure or 21. This needs to be continued at least till age of 60, pap smear. Try and avoid doing the pap smear when a lady is in menses. That's a very important take home point. And remember that there are two ways of doing pap smear. Okay, this is very basic information. One is the conventional method. As I said, in the conventional method, what happens is there is a slide. So whatever you smeared gets smeared on the slide and you are examining the side. And second thing is, which all of you would have heard of, is called as LBC, is called as liquid based cytology. Okay. So the basic difference between the two is, in order to do conventional pap smear, you just need a spatula. See, there is something called as an IR spatula. It is something like this. See, I've just drawn the spatula here. Can you see this in black? Rashmi Ben, it is visible?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, this is a common IR spatula. So what it does is, it takes something from the endocervix also. It takes something from the exocervix also. Okay. And this spatula is then smeared on the slide. And what is LBC? LBC is available with a brush. See, there is a brush like this, like bristles, like how we have our toothbrush, like that a big brush is available. And this brush then takes it and fixes it instead of the slide, no? It fixes it straight on the media. So this is slightly more expensive as compared to conventional. Both are equally good. All you need to have is a very, very good pathologist to report liquid-based cytology reports to you. Okay? Just for routine practical purposes, try and remember that in Indian women, you would like to avoid doing a pap smear when they come in menses. Otherwise, pap smear should begin, the screening should begin from the age of 21, should continue at least till 60. And I believe all practicing family physicians should start doing it in their OPDs, especially a female family physician. All right. So let me just stop the screen sharing for all of you. And let me come back to the normal screen. Right. We are back. Please remember that pap smear, as I said, is basically you are trying to study the cells of this transformative zone. You will be surprised to know, in these cells, you will also pick up endometrial cancer. In these cells, you will also pick up other bacterial infection. In these cells, you will pick up cancer of the cervix, occult cancer of the cervix, or early cancer of the cervix. Advanced cancer of the cervix is visible. You put a Cusco speculum and it bleeds on touch. Very simple. That's completely visible. The importance of doing this is, quite a lot of times there are family physicians who don't know only what they are studying in the pap smear. All they know is that it is reported as chronic cervicitis. All they know is that it is reported as high grade lesion of unknown origin, atypical cell of unknown origin. They are not knowing the basics. I believe this session is going to be important because it helps you understand the basics of what is pap smear. In my next session, I'm going to teach you what is a colposcopy and how, as a family physician, you can practically try and understand the reports of